Now, you see, what is, let me speak specifically for a moment. I said the subject of this is LSD. LSD is one such chemical that does produce this curious effect of making you aware of the polarity of things. It does lots of other things. It does lots of rather unessential and trivial things. And these, of course, in all the publicity in the various national magazines about LSD, get thoroughly emphasized. In other words, when somebody says something's real psychedelic, they mean bizarre. And when the national magazines try to illustrate the effect of these chemicals with various photographs, they come on with blurred photographs of all sorts of things higgledy-piggledy messed together. Naked girls seen through prisms. Well, that's absolutely nothing to do with it. If you wanted some sort of appropriate illustration for a Life magazine article on the effects of LSD, you would have one very simple solution. You would publish the most gorgeous color reproductions of Persian miniatures and of Moorish arabesques and of the illuminations of Celtic manuscripts. That would give you the story. So far as changes in human sensation are concerned.
existence, you see, is something that is spontaneous. The Chinese word for nature, Zilan, means that which happens of itself. Your hair grows by itself. Your heart beats by itself. You breathe pretty much by itself. Your glands secrete their essences by themselves. You don't have voluntary control over these things. So we say it happens spontaneously. So when you go to sleep, and you try to go to sleep, you interfere with the spontaneous process of going to sleep. Try to breathe, you know, real hard. You find that it balled up in your breathing. So, if you've got to be human, you just have to trust yourself to have bowel movements and go to sleep, and digest your food.
Thank you. Just made my whole heart.